வெல்கம் பேக். இலங்கையின் தேசிய நாடாளுமன்ற தேசிய பட்டியல் நாடாளுமன்ற உறுப்பினர் கலாநிதி ஜெயம்பதி விக்ரமரத்ன அவர்களுடன் இலங்கையின் புதிய அரசியல் ஆப்பினுடைய உருவாக்கம் குறித்து நாங்கள் விரிவாக கலந்துரையாடிக் கொண்டிருக்கிறோம். டாக்டர், டெல் அஸ்.
People in the Northeast have a special problem.
They have a special problem because
so are you trying to generalize that they have the same issues that the people have in the Monragla?
No. I think I'm not saying that. But I stand for devolution as a solution to the ethnic issue as well as a solution to the development, underdevelopment issue. In the case of the North and East, which is dominated by Tamils and Muslims, who don't have a fair share of power in the center. So wherever in the world you have a concentrated community, which is numerically smaller, you have this demand for self-rule. It is nothing but natural that concentrated communities ask for state power. When a community is dispersed in a country, they can't ask for devolution. They ask for equality, equal rights, language rights, schools, admission, all that. Just representation in the institutions of government. But the moment that a numerically smaller community is concentrated, then the demand is for cultural identity in political form. And that is how the demand for the share of state power comes. Look at any country, any dispersed community, it may be at various levels, but they're asking for power. And in countries where power has been, sharing of state power has been denied, what has happened? You naturally have secessionist tendencies, federalists. First you ask for federalism, like happened in Sri Lanka. The Tamils did not ask for federalism. It is Bandaranaike who asked for federalism in 1926. It is the Candian chiefs who went before the Salisbury Commission and before that the Donoma Commission and said there must be three federal units in Sri Lanka. And it is the Candian chiefs who suggested that the North and East should be merged. That there should be a separate unit, federal unit for the North and East, right? So, but 1949 changed it all. At that time, there was no federal party. The Tamil parties were all in, Tamil people, politicians were all in the Tamil Congress, sharing power happily in Colombo with the UNP. But when the UNP-led government took away the voting rights, And exclusion of Indian people of the hill country Tamils from citizenship. Then only Chalonayagam said, look, this is not going to work. This power sharing in Colombo is not going to work. Look, our cousins in the hill country have been disenfranchised and we can't do a thing about it. So let's at least ask for federalism. But then what happened in the 1952 elections, federalism was decisively rejected by the Tamil people. Chalonayagam himself lost in Kankasanthure, not to a Tamil Congress candidate, but to a UNP candidate called Nadesan. And the federal party got only two seats. The people of that North and East rejected federalism even in 1952. But what changed it all was 1955, when the SLFP and the UNP changed its policy from Sinhala and Tamil as official languages to Sinhala only as official languages. Then the moment they changed this in the South, only we in the left party stuck to parity, right? The moment that happened, there was the reaction in the North and East. But and in 1956, let me continue it, the change happened. Federal party became very strong. The Tamil Congress down to two seats. They never recovered from that.
No, but now the, you are in the steering committee of the Constitutional Assembly. You invite people to give, make their proposals. The Northern Provincial Council and the people in the North, Tamil Peravai, Tamil Makkal Peravai, has submitted their proposals. They said about the federalism, they talk about merger of the North East, they talk about self-determination and all that. But that has been badly hit, I mean, badly reacted in the South. The provincial government minister, chief minister, Vigneswaran has made that proposal and is about to be handed over to the TNA leader and then to be transferred to the government or the central government.
மாற்றங்களுடன் இன்று முன்வைக்கப்பட்டிருக்கும் அரசியல் தீர்வு மற்றும் அரசியல் யாப்புக்கான கொள்கை வரைவு தொடர்பான இந்த முன்மொழிவுகள் தெற்கிலே ஏற்கனவே கௌரவ முதலமைச்சர் கூறியது போல இதில் என்ன இருக்குது என்ன சொல்ல போறோம்ன்றதை நாங்களே முடிவு செய்ய முதல் தெற்கிலே இதற்கு எதிர்ப்பான எதிரலைகள் கிளம்ப ஆரம்பித்து விட்டன. இதுதான் தமிழர்களின் வரலாறாக இருந்திருக்கின்றது. ஆனால் அந்த வரலாறு தொடர முடியாது. எனக்கு ஞாபகம் இருக்கின்றது, கௌரவ எதிர்க்கட்சி தலைவர் அமுதலிங்கம் அவர்களை பாராளுமன்றத்திலிருந்து வெளியேற்றும் மூலமாக அரசியலமைப்பின் ஆறாவது திருத்தம் கொண்டு வரப்பட்ட போது கௌரவ தொண்டமானவர்கள் அப்போது ஜேஆர் அவர்கள் அவரை சுதந்திரமாக பேச அனுமதித்திருந்தார். கட்சி கட்டுப்பாடு இல்லாமல் அவர் அரசுடன் இருந்தாலும் அவர் குறிப்பிட்டது எனக்கு இன்றைக்கு ஞாபகமாக இருக்கின்றது. அரசியல் யாப்பு என்பது மனிதர்களால் ஆக்கப்படும் ஒன்று. அது இன்றைக்கு ஒன்றாக இருக்கலாம், நாளைக்கு இன்னொன்றாக இருக்கலாம், நாளை இன்றைக்கு இன்னொன்றாக இருக்கலாம். அந்த அரசியல் யாப்பில் என்ன இருக்க வேண்டும் என்று சொல்லுகின்ற சுதந்திரம் எங்களுக்கு வேண்டும். அந்த சுதந்திரத்தை தான் இந்த மாகாண சபை இன்று செய்து கொண்டிருக்கின்றது. இந்த தமிழ் மக்களுடைய அபிலாசைகளாக, தமிழ் மக்களுடைய எண்ணத்திலே இதுவரை என்ன தோன்றியிருக்கின்றது அரசியலமைப்பு மாற்றம் வேண்டும் என்றதை நாங்கள் அபிலாசைகளை ஒட்டுமொத்தமாக தொகுத்து ஏற்கனவே கௌரவ முதலமைச்சர் சொன்னது போல இந்த சபையின் சார்பாக நாங்கள் அரசுக்கு முன்வைக்க இந்த முயற்சி எடுக்கப்பட்டிருக்கின்றது. இதில் ஒன்றென்று சில தவறுகள் குறைபாடுகள் இருக்கலாம், அது திருத்தப்படக்கூடியவை. ஆனால் ஒட்டுமொத்தமாக தமிழ் மக்கள் இதுவரை அனுபவித்த இல்லாடி இந்த நிலைமைக்கு தள்ளப்பட்ட காரணிகளையும் நாங்கள் இங்கு எடுத்து வியம்பி அத்துடன் கூடவே இந்த அரசியலமைப்பு மாற்றம் எவ்வாறு இருக்க வேண்டும் என்ற விடயத்தை இந்த முன்மொழிவுகள் பரிந்துரை செய்கின்றன.
As a member of the Constitution Assembly, how do you react to their principle and the reaction from the South? To the proposals,
I think,
when they make proposals, you react very badly.
I think every citizen of Sri Lanka has the right to make any proposal. They may be too extreme, the proposal. I haven't studied them, I must say. But I've read that most of it is in the long, long preamble, right?
Absolutely.
Right? So I accept the right of any citizen or any citizen's organization to make representations. So you can't deny to them the right to make representations. Acceptance is a different issue. So we as a member of the steering committee, I have a duty to consider any representation made to on the issue by any citizen's organization. So we have to understand that. And acceptance is a different issue.
But the steering committee, one of the members, Lal Vijayanayake, had told the
Mr. Vijayanayake is not in the steering committee. He chairs the public representations committee.
Yes, that consulting committee has told that the government will not change in the unitary character of the state. And
You have to ask Mr. Vijayanayake.
Last week there was a press conference at the information department auditorium. Minister Lakshman Yapabeyavartan has reacted to a statement about the federalism. Let's watch that.
No, I know that. I've seen that, right? And so that is his party's position.
But he said the president has completely rejected federalism.
Government has not decided. Then it must come out as a cabinet decision. The government has not decided. That may be the position of the Sri Lanka Freedom Party, not to have federalism. As much as I respect the right of the Northern Provincial Council to call for federalism, I also respect the right of any other political party to say that we are not for federalism. Finally, a consensus has to be evolved, taking all this into consideration.
But Lal Vijayanayake is from your party.
No, Lal Vijayanayake, I don't think the government, I never saw a statement which says the government has decided to reject federalism. No, he may have seen.
We have Lakshman Yapa, Abhay
Vardhanas. පලාත් සභාවල ඕන කෙනෙකුට ඕන දෙයක් ඒගොල්ලන්ට කතා කරන්න පුළුවන්. නමුත් ප්‍රතිපත්තිමේ තීන්දුවක් ගන්නකොට මේ රජයයි ප්‍රතිපත්තිමේ තීන්දුව ගන්න. ඒතර ප්‍රතිපත්තියේ තීන්දුව ගන්නකන ෆෙඩරල් ක්‍රමයක් එනවා නම් කොහොමද මේ රටේ? ෆෙඩරල් ක්‍රමයක් එනවා නම් කැබිනට් මණ්ඩලයෙන් අනුමත කරන්න ඕන. පාර්ලිමේන්තුවට යන්න ඕන. පාර්ලිමේන්තුවේ අනුමත කරන්න ඕන. ව්‍යවස්ථාව වෙනස් කරන්න ඕන. තුනෙන් දෙකේ ඡන්දයට යන්න ඕන. අධිකරණයට ගියොත් ජනමත විචාරණයකට යන්න ඕන. මේ ප්‍රොසීඩියර් එක සම්පූර්ණයෙන් මේ ක්‍රමවේදයේ තියෙද්දි කොහෙවත්ින දේශපාලනඥයෝ එක කතා කරයි කියලා ඒ දේශපාලනඥයෝගේ පක්ෂ අපිත් එක්ක ආවා කියලා අපිට කිසි ගැටලුවක් නැහැ. ජයලලිතත් මෙහෙ පෙඩරල් හදන. හැබැයි ජයලලිතට ලංකාවේ පෙඩරල් හදන්න බෑනේ. ජයලලිතට කතා කරන්න පුළුවන්. හැබැයි පෙඩරල් හදන්න නම් පෙඩරල් හදන ක්‍රමවේදයක් තියෙනවා. ජනාධිපතිතුමායි තාමත් පැහැදිලිව කියලා තියෙනවා. රජය පැහැදිලිව කිව්වා පෙඩරල් ක්‍රමයකට එකඟ නැහැ. ඉතින් ඊට වඩා කතා කරන්න දෙයක් නැහැ. පෙඩරල් ක්‍රමයට අපි එකඟ නැත්තම්
Doctor, the minister is saying this, the president has completely rejected federalism. What do you have to say about it?
I have that is his position. That must be his party's position. You have to ask him that question. I am not here to represent the government. I am here to represent myself and the party to which I belong. Our position is that any political party or any political organization or the provincial council or local authority should have the right to make his representation. Finally, it's a matter for parliament to decide, because the parliament has to come out with a two-thirds majority. If parliament does, two-thirds majority of parliament do not agree on a federal solution, it won't happen. But the right to say that, right to propose that is accepted.
But we see, is it possible that compromise is it possible within this present arrangement?
I think you have to come to a compromise. My own view is that you have to compromise. I am against this, but that is what I say, this drop these labels, right? The moment if the provincial council asks for clear cut division of powers rather than fighting for long preambles and labels, then this wouldn't have arisen. I think if I was in the north, I wouldn't have done that. I would have rather talked about the content of the new constitution rather than labels.
No, but you talk about compromise.
The compromise I propose is not to have labels, if possible not to have labels, and but ensure that devolution is protected by the constitution. The extent of devolution should be meaningful, and devolution provision should be protected in the constitution. That is what I stand for. That I think is a very good compromise, rather than fighting over labels and about labels.
But with the TNA being the main opposition party, do you think things are simple and easy to take forward the right?
You won't get this opportunity again. You have the president and the prime minister coming from the two main political parties, working together in government. You have the TNA, which is supportive of the government. So you won't have another opportunity. So let's make the best out of it. You won't get the best constitution. You won't get the best constitution, but we need to get the best constitution in the circumstances possible.
No, but again, the question remains, without the major parties coming together on a proposal on the devolution of powers, what compromise that can expect from
they need to discuss it. What about the Muslim parties, right?
That's what I'm
not
asking,
only yes. The Tamils, but less. So it has to be discussed. That is why the steering committee has taken on to itself the task of agreeing on the principles of devolution. That will be dealt at the steering committee level without giving it to a subcommittee. So in the steering committee, we hope to come to a compromise.
Is there any foreign pressure or foreign input with regard to the
Not at all, not at all. I have heard this, that That's there are people who are drafting and how the constitution, there are people from other countries, not at all. And let me make it clear that not a single sentence of the proposed constitution has been drafted. If that has been drafted, I should know.
And when do you expect to come out with it?
No, there is no timeline, but everybody agrees that it is sooner the better. We don't have to reinvent the wheel. There are enough drafts available. The 2000 draft, the experts panel, the APRC, the Bill of Rights Committee, the Mangala Munasinghe report, there are enough and more. We don't need experts from outside. We have enough expertise and enough documents. What is important is for the parties to agree on what should go into the Constitution.
Now, you are in the steering committee of the Constitution Assembly. Do you think the minority rights or the people rights of the Tamils and the Muslims will be guaranteed and secured in the new constitution?
For them. My position is that the new constitution should have provisions safeguarding the rights of all communities. There is no question about it. I stand for that.
You being a left member, yes, you have been standing for it for a long time. But does this government, new government, has the will for it?
It has. Definitely. My discussions with people at the leadership level convinces me that it has the desire, it has had the necessary commitment. My worry is about the opposition, people who sit in the opposition, who want to sabotage the process, who will definitely want to sabotage the process. So let us all be wary of that also.
So it's not a deadline, but when do you think the new constitution?
Ideally, within 1 year, I would, speaking for myself,
yeah.
I would like to see the referendum process, the constitutional process and the referendum be held within this year.
Doctor, thanks for joining us. Thanks a lot. We have shed light on the constitutional and making of the new constitution. நல்லது நேர்களே, புதிய அரசியலமைப்பு தொடர்பாக அதனை உருவாக்க தொடர்பாக அதனுடைய செயற்குழு இருக்கக்கூடிய கலாநிதி தேம்பதி விக்ரமரட்னம் அவர்கள் இதுவரை புதிய அரசியல் யாப்பில் அடங்கக்கூடிய விடயங்கள் என்ன, அது முகம் கொடுத்துள்ள சவால்கள் என்ன, அநேகமாக அடுத்த ஒரு வருடத்துக்குள் ஒரு புதிய அரசியல் யாப்பு இலங்கையில் ஏற்படுத்தப்பட்டு விடும் என்ற நம்பிக்கை அவர் வெளியிட்டிருக்கிறார். நல்லது நேர்களே, இத்துடன் நிகழ்ச்சி நிறைவு செய்து கொள்கிறோம். மற்றொரு நிகழ்ச்சி சந்திக்கும் வரை மூடமென்று விடப்பெற்றுக் கொண்டான் பி கருணாகரன். நன்றி, வணக்கம்.